Ask Reddit.
What strange things do your neighbors do? Every time I go outside, my neighbors go inside. Every time. They drop everything they're doing and go inside. However, if I start washing my vehicle, my neighbor's husband will start washing his vehicle. But wait, there's more. I bought a 2010 Ford Ranger, white. Then they bought a white Ford Ranger. I bought a pool. They bought a pool. I built a big shed. They built a shed, albeit a smaller shed, but it is a shed nevertheless. What the shit is going on? My parents' neighbor will mow his lawn every single time my dad does. Dad will even wait until the day after neighbor mows, and neighbor will mow again. People are fucking weird. Okay, the first sentence I thought, well, maybe he's just sensitive about disturbing the neighbors with noise, so he does it when they're already making noise. But that second sentence kicks it up to weird, for sure. A couple of things could be at play. It could be a trigger. Oh fuck, I forgot to mow the lawn, so Starcy Star's dad is doing it, I better get going, this could become a habit, or fuck this noise, can't get shit done in the house, might as well mow the lawn. Back when I was in high school, the guy next door to me was the same age. Every time my parents made me mow the lawn, his parents made him mow the lawn. Every time he mowed the lawn, my parents would make me mow the lawn. Mostly because they felt the lawn looked shabby in comparison to the neighbor's newly mowed lawn. They stole my garbage can. Like, the fuck you stealing my garbage can for? I now have 3 recycling bins because the wind blows them into our yard. I regularly let people know we have extras, and if they're missing one, they can come get it, but no one ever does. So if you need a recycling bin because your neighbor took it, let me know. This is why you write your address on it, people. We used our old trash can 4 times before someone stole it. Twice a week for 2 weeks, we didn't even have it for a month. It looked identical to a lot of other people's in the neighborhood, so this time we spray painted the lid pure white, along with the address. It's so distinct no one's touched it since. My neighbor regularly plays the drums loudly at odd hours, but worse than that is he sometimes plays jungle noises and Halloween music out of season. He's also got a headless false torso on his house that faces our backyard. Yeah, I don't blame you. I hate when people play jungle noises out of season too. Unga 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 unga, that's it, I'm drawing the line, I'm gonna tell Frank to cut it with the fucking jungle noises before the Sun Festival. Honey, don't do that, come here and enjoy a coffee. I'm done sitting down for coffee, Rose. Are you really complicating our marriage over jungle music? It's not his fault he unearthed Jumanji. She steals people's cats if they get out. And she says weirdly ominous things to me from over the fence when I get into my car, like, you know. If your house caught on fire, you would probably only have 3 minutes to get out, or my Nova is built out of better material than your car. If I happen to hit you while you're backing out, I could kill you and your son. One day I caught her going through stuff in my garage, so we put up no trespassing signs and motion sensor lights. I've also caught her going through my garbage and taking an old bent curtain rod I threw away. She also used to go down into my landlord's yard, which is behind mine, and poke holes into her inflatable pool. And she leaves her poor pit bull chained in her yard all day every day. She's fucking nuts and she's trash. You should get those cameras outside your house. Bitch sounds crazy. My landlord actually set some up outside of her own house whenever I caught the neighbor deflating her pool. She has a few facing my property too, and she hasn't been in either of our yards since. Still crazy though. My landlord has cats, and one of them prefers to be outdoors. Since the lady next door is also a hoarder and dirty, there are a lot of rodents up there, and the cat keeps them from getting in our yards and houses. Well, that cat got pregnant and crazy neighbor lady trapped her until she gave birth, stole her kittens and tried to sell them to me. She is literally crazy. Letting an unfixed cat out is a pretty shitty thing to do. The mom stands on our shared patio and watches her 2 kids bang on the glass door to make my dog bark like crazy. They bark back at him. Then she pretends to not speak English when I bring it up. My mom had an issue with this when we lived overseas. We lived beside a coffee plantation, and the kids who picked up the coffee beans would come up to the gate and run back and forth, harassing our Doberman and working her up. She got after them, but they continue to do this. So one day, when she saw the kids walking up the driveway to bug the dog, she opened the gate and let the dog out. They saw Cindy gunning for them and ran like hell and never did it again. Of course, this dog was incredibly well trained, and it was the late 70s in Colombia, so it might not be an appropriate solution for you in your situation. But I would hose the kids down for sure.
There's a pathway beside my house through to the next street, diagonally behind me, which is behind my next door neighbor, is a guy who lives in a caravan behind his sister's house. He is a raging alcoholic, and his caravan windows are filthy with smoke residue and lined with empty bottles. It's hot here and they are often open, and you can see him in there watching TV. When you walk down the pathway, his dog will bark and he yells obscenities at it to stop. Last year he was using power tools for about 4 hours every day for months. It seemed as though he was doing repairs to the caravan, but its general appearance never improved. More recently, he must have hit a rough patch because he's been smashing bottles on the path, throwing them over the fence. A couple of weeks ago, a stranger walks down the pathway while I'm talking to my next door neighbor, the one who's lucky to have an adjoining fence with this guy. He asks if we've seen anyone coming down the path, as there was a mutilated blue-tongued lizard sitting in the middle of it. We said no, and he informed us he'd moved it to the side of the path. I can't be certain it was him, but it seems kind of likely. So I'm chatting with the neighbor about him, and she tells me they hate him because they can't use their back porch when they have friends over at all. Because one night they did and he came over with a machete to threaten them. I've never heard these neighbors be noisy, and we often have people over. They call the police on him. Apparently he isn't allowed near their house anymore. I walked down the path the next day, and the lizard smelled terrible and was right next to his caravan. We went on holidays right after, and when we came back a couple of weeks later, no one had bothered to move it, and just the skin and bones were left.
I live in an apartment that has at least 50 people, and I've only seen 5 of them ever. In 1 year. Man, I've had this too at previous places I've lived. I could hear doors opening closing occasionally, but it could be weeks between actually seeing somebody. It's weird because I'd assume at least someone else would leave for work and come home at the same hour. Nope. This is much better than my neighbors. I constantly run into them on the elevator, and there are only 16 apartments here. Almost any time I go out, it's like they wait to hear the elevator and try to catch it as it comes down. I swear my neighbor opens their door right when I'm trying to leave. It's me. I was the weird neighbor. Preface. I grew up on a huge rural property with plants and chickens and what have you wandering around. So when I move into a tiny ground floor city apartment with a shared, but mostly abandoned, garden, I did what any gardening addict did. I set up planter boxes. That same week there was a sale on googly eyes at the discount store, so, logically, I decided to glue googly eyes on all my plants. This solved my I miss my pets problem. I used to spend my early morning before work pottering around my plants and chatting away to myself. I didn't realize any of this was weird until one of the neighbor's grandkids bravely opened her back door and bravely asked me who I was talking to. I ended up teaching her all the names of the plants, their real names and their googly eye names, and gave her my garden when I moved out. Edit. Gold for my weirdness. Thank you for the positive reinforcement, stranger. That's just a push I need to fill my new apartment balcony with more plants. My girlfriend grew up in the country her whole life, and now that she lives in an apartment, she is loud as fuck. Like talking like an idiot super loud to the cat, yelling at me, just being generally loud and crazy. It's not mean yelling, just loud talking yelling across house stuff. I still love her though. I'm constantly harped on for being loud. It kind of is the perfect storm too. Grew up around loud machinery, dad is a diesel mechanic, has a tractor, loud power tools, always has TV, music, games too loud even in headphones. My whole family is loud and is used to yelling for each other, not at, we are just loud, and I also happen to have a big chest and lungs. So I'm just loud as fuck. Everyone but my family has told me I'm loud. My girlfriend constantly, it also doesn't help that she is quiet a lot of the time.